Je suis Sapé Makengele, artiste, peintre, dessinateur. Je viens du Congo Kinshasa.
My name is Usama Khaydi. I am a Moroccan student doing a Master of Arts in African Studies at Leiden University. I am also an independent journalist in the Central African Republic and the trainee at Al Jazeera Media Institute.
Ma trajectoire pour venir en Europe, je suis venu à travers l'invitation de l'université de Leiden et l'invitation des regroupements familiaux, car je vis avec une famille ici. Ma recherche, il s'agit de mes compatriotes congolais qui vivent ici aux Pays-Bas. Je voulais découvrir leur expérience de vie, hein, car il y a beaucoup d'autres qui ont passé déjà plus de 30 ans ici. Alors, je veux mieux savoir leur parcours, leur mode de vie.
My research is about the Congolese diaspora in the Netherlands. My research is also in a partnership with the Trafic and the European Union, who are also looking into the migration and mobility of the refugees in Europe in generally. Also, I got interested in this topic, especially from a perspective of social classes, and to investigate the vertical inequalities in the Congolese social classes, and also to investigate if migration plays a significant role in the horizontal mobility of the Congolese when they migrate here in the Netherlands. What I mean by vertical inequalities is the inequalities that occurs within social classes. For instance, the upper middle class can be privileged in some way than the lower class, which might also cause for the lower class to migrate more often than the upper class. And what I mean with the horizontal social mobility is, in a way, for instance, if we take an example of a person who is seen as a Congolese elite, and then when he or she migrates to Europe or in the Netherlands, they end up finding themselves categorized with the Dutch lower class, maybe. And also, it can go the other way around. Some people who are belongs to the lower middle class in Congo can come here and do really amazing things. And I think there's an example of a Dutch deputy from a Congolese origin who also kind of traveled from, let's say, the Congolese periphery to the Dutch elite. This research is unique, you know, in the data collected, because it's not just one-on-one interview and that's it, but it's more of following people's life with many interviews and many interactions, many ethnographic observation. So we are in the process of going with around 20 stories of Congolese people living and based in the Netherlands.
Les défis de la recherche, c'est d'entrer vraiment dans leur côté privé pour le faire parler. Ça, c'est le tout premier défi sur cette recherche. Et puis, dans les périodes ici, les corona, Covid-19, c'est un des défis aussi qui essaie de nous paralyser, mais on essaie quand même de se débrouiller avec.
We faced few challenges in regards that our research participants are have an illegal status here, and thus it's almost impossible to make them kind of talk and tell us their stories. So it's hard to initiate the trust, but thanks to Sapin, I mean, we are getting their trust, and Sapin gives the research more legitimacy and trustfulness in the eye of the Congolese.
La peinture touche un peu le thème de la recherche, hein? Car si tu vois, il y a beaucoup de personnes qu'on connaît ici qui viennent de l'Afrique, ils ont fait des voyages vraiment très difficiles, hein? L'immigration clandestine, venir en Europe également. Et les autres réussissent de partir jusqu'à leur destination. Mais il y a beaucoup d'autres que je pense qu'ils restent dans la mer. Donc la raison pour laquelle que vous voyez, j'ai intitulé la peinture « La mort méditerranée ».